You told us back in May that you thought this would be the biggest year ever in terms of the number of listings. You were predicting about 40 back then, listings in total. Have you hit that target?
We haven't hit that target yet. There's almost 30 that have listed in the U.S. Most of them, thankfully, have chosen to list with NASDAQ, so we're very, very proud of that. So last year there were 38. I thought that we had breached 40. We'll probably get to close to 35 to 38 again this year. I mean, Nancy, we had that volatility in the market.
Sure.
We had this thing called the trade war. I don't know that's been going on.
Haven't heard of it.
That's been a little bit of an issue. And then some of the deals just have, as we got through the summer, pushed to the fall. And some of the fall deals have pushed to maybe into next year. So.
You mentioned the trade war, and I wonder what impact that's having specifically. Is it about the slowdown in China in terms of companies perhaps losing their appetite to list, or is it more about a reluctance for Chinese companies to list in the United States?
It's definitely not about the reluctance of companies to list in the U.S. In fact, it's almost counterintuitive the way that the listings business has continued to grow between Chinese companies wanting to list in the U.S. So, as I said, 38 companies last year. I had thought we'd certainly do more than 40 this year. I think it's really the fact that investors are worried about China. They're worried about the ripple effects of the trade war, and so therefore some of the valuations haven't really come in exactly where the companies would have wanted. And I think they were waiting for there to be some more certainty. As you've seen in the U.S. markets, every time President Xi or President Trump, usually President Trump on Twitter, but says something positive about the way that the talks are going, the market rallies. And every time there's a sense that they aren't going well, then the market sells off. And so you see that it's really the most important topic in the U.S. and one that the Chinese companies looking to the U.S. are looking for some certainty around.
And the question I have to you is, if we get a phase one deal, which the market seems to be fairly hopeful that we could get at least a phase one deal between the U.S. and China, would that be enough to remove this uncertainty you're describing?
I think so.
You do? Even if we don't get substantial changes to intellectual property and structural issues resolved?
I do, because at the end of the day, a lot of those things have really nothing to do with how companies are going to list process of them listing in the U.S. Many of these companies, most of these companies, have already done their structures, obviously the VIE structure, to do an offshore listing. To take that down and to do a domestic listing is timely and costly, and so a lot of them have already made the decision to list outside of the local markets. And when we think a company should is going to list outside the local markets, we think NASDAQ's the right place. So that's what we're here to talk about the benefits of NASDAQ with those companies all the time.
How much concern do you encounter by these companies, though, just about the political rhetoric at the moment? Some tied specifically to Chinese companies listing in the U.S. We've heard advisors to the president. We've heard former advisors to the president give their opinion that there needs to be a rule change entirely, that perhaps some Chinese companies should be delisted from the United States. Does that worry you?
Well, I think you've all heard me on. I ended up being the cover story of the South China Morning Post earlier, as somehow my WeChat messages became viral in China. But we at NASDAQ run a market that is non-discriminatory, that is inclusive, and that welcomes companies from around the world. Anyone that meets the regulations and the requirements to list in the U.S. We honestly don't believe that some of the rhetoric that's coming out of Washington, including people that were formerly associated with the administration, are exactly where things are going to go. I'm talking about Steve Bannon. But I also think that any of the others that have spoken negatively about the path that Chinese companies have to the U.S., I don't think that is the way that the process is going to play out. I think that things like potentially the pension funds of the U.S. government employees not being able to invest in Chinese stocks, that might happen. But the reality is that something like that doesn't invest in IPOs. And so it's not an area where I have great concern for the opportunity for companies to access the U.S. capital markets, and we're going to welcome them to NASDAQ as often as they want to come.